This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
Choose a color, choose a flavor.
Adzuki bean, it's a Japanese red bean, always on the menu.
Shop.
It's so convincing and lifelike that people constantly ask us if they're real jellyfish.
Read independent bookstores. Remember them? Listen.
It's basically just music and chairs, and if that's not enough for you, don't show up.
Across the Charles.
Still has a considerable funk factor.
It's hip to be square. Offbeat Inman Square. Practical Porter Square. In Central Square.
It's going to be a new flux of housing that will come into the community.
Big change is on the way. Anything but square. Next on Chronicle.
Good evening, everyone. Cambridge is a destination for arts, food, and culture, and its squares feature all of those in abundance.
And tonight we're hitting a few of them. First stop, the only major square not on the red line, independent Inman Square. Everyone knows Cambridge's squares are anything but. And as the only major Cambridge square without a T-stop, Inman Square might be the most off-center of them all.
It still has a considerable funk factor.
Still have some artists living around here, musicians. Kind of reminds me of like a neighborhood in Brooklyn that hasn't quite been caught on to the rest of Brooklyn yet.
Inman Square is probably best known to the outside world for its lively food scene. From the meat comas being induced at the Brazilian Midwest Grill on one end to the chicken and waffles served up at Trina's Starlight Lounge on the other. In between everything from the trendy to traditional. For all its creative energies, Inman Square retains a strong working class streak. Practical retail coexists alongside hipster hangs, a combination found in miniature at Practice Space.
The idea is that the experience is immersive, but the stuff isn't frivolous. The stuff is useful.
Diana Lempel and Nicole Latuca curate a small collection of beautiful, practical objects in their cozy storefront retail space. Cards, clothing, housewares, and artwork. In the back, their design studio. With each passing season, they conjure a new theme for their store. This spring, it's How Can Wonder Make Our City Better? Inventory, colors, and art themes follow.
Our goal is for the space to look pretty different from season to season and feel different.
And people have come in and said, oh, they always think we're like a pop-up because we change kind of consistently.
On the next block, the creative pattern continues.
You are at Gather Here, and we are a fabric and fibers studio makerspace right in the heart of Inman Square.
Virginia Johnson keeps busy as a costume supervisor on movie and TV sets, but her true passion, sharing her love of needle and thread.
I have been sewing since I was six, started knitting around then too, and I mean, I loved it so much I decided to start a business around it.
Gather Here has everything the modern maker could ask for, buttons, yarns, even high-end sewing machines. Every evening there are classes, but most importantly perhaps, Gather Here offers community.
When we realized that the experiment was actually going to work, we started looking for spaces that could accommodate the actual lust for creativity that we found in Cambridge and in Somerville. We didn't feel that like Harvard Square was really us, but Inman felt right.
Inman Square's nightlife has long been anchored by the venerable jazz club, Ryle's. But for those seeking stranger sonic adventures, a back alley alternative.
We've been here for 10 years this fall as Outpost.
Outpost 186, hidden away in the back of an old three-decker. There's music here almost every night of the week. Free jazz, experimental, and improv.
Basically, bars have rock, DJs, karaoke, and alcohol, and we have everything else.
Rob Chalfin is the mastermind behind this rather austere micro scene, where admission charges are but a suggestion, alcohol a dream.
It's basically just music and chairs, and if that's not enough for you, don't show up, basically.
If the Outpost leaves you craving a little self-indulgence, Christina's Ice Cream might be just the place. Since 1983, this has been the go-to place for Inman Square folk craving a decent kulfi cone or adzuki bean ice cream.
Adzuki bean, it's a Japanese red bean, always on the menu. It's been on the menu for 25 years.
Wow, Japanese red bean. Well, In addition to Japanese red bean, Christina, of course, offers all the favorites that people love and expect.
They experiment a lot with fresh herbs, you know, seasonal flavors, flowers, All these different sorts of things, which is kind of fun. And they've made a lot of best of lists, including some national lists, Bon Appetit magazine, Travel and Leisure. So they're making a name for themselves, and it's getting around.
I think I need to check out Christina's. All right, now take a look at tomorrow's Central Square.
Soon to come on Mass Ave, a 308-unit apartment complex, Mass in Maine.